Papa bon Dieu, nous ka remercie ou pour tout ça que ou ka fait ban nous. Nous ka remercie ou pour permettre que nous nion moun kon Earl Bousquet à St.lucia qui ka porté information qui très important qui ka kebe moun à dans lumière pour yo comprendre plus meilleur ça qui ka fait dans les rôles là té là. Nous commande ou des béni nation là, nous commande ou des béni programme là, nous commande ou des béni tout ça qui ka fait dans la terre, à dans l'intérêt moun qui pauvre. Nous commande ou assister nation qui en difficulté. Nous commande ou protéger la terre là contre tout désastre qui ça fait. Et nous commande ou aussi prolonger la vie Earl Bousquet qui c'est un homme exceptionnel que bon Dieu permette qu'il ni à dans St.lucia pour Caribbean là et pour Jean la terre là aussi. Merci papa bon Dieu pour tout. Béni programme là, béni ces moun là, béni hol la terre.
Bonjour, ça ka fait est ou bien. Bonjour, ça ka fait est ou bien. Bonjour, ça ka fait est ou bien. Moi ka souhaite ou en bonne journée. Bonjour, ça ka fait est ou bien. Bonjour, ça ka fait est ou bien. Bonjour, ça ka fait est ou bien. Moi ka souhaite ou en bonne journée.
Hello and happy Sunday, everyone, wherever you are, and welcome to the 17th edition of Earl at Large on this, the first day of October, the first Sunday of the 10th month of 2023, and the first Sunday of Creole Heritage Month, Mois Héritage Creole, during which, of course, as always, we observe, among other traditional events, the La Marguerite Flower Festival on October 17th and International Creole Day on the Sunday closest to October 25th, which will pose a problem this year if it's not already chosen, as October 25th falls in on a Wednesday, which, according to my calendar, is in the middle of the week and equidistant from the two closest Sundays. So which Sunday will be the feast of St. Margaret, the patron saint of the Margaret flower? Well, we will get to know a little later in the program. But by then, there's so much already ready for observance of four decades of Journée Creole in the past 50 years. And we'll hear more about that later, too. As well as about the 50th anniversary of the Folk Research Center, which we normally called FRC, but has had a name change that we will also let you know about a little later. Today is also the second Sunday since the United States announced that it was putting up $65 million U.S. dollars for what I like to refer to as a bounty for Haiti, to repeat what happened in Grenada 40 years ago next month, or in fact later this month, on the 25th of this month. But we'll come back to that later. And of course, it's another super hot climate change Sunday with Earl at Large, when and where we share the knowledge of happenings at home across the region and the world, and the common visions for better for all in the constant struggle for most in this global concrete jungle meant to house and feed all, but in which, as you see, over 821 million people, folks, and this is no laughing matter. 821 million people, including wherever you are right now, go to sleep every night hungry or without a proper meal and with no dreams for a better tomorrow. So, wherever you are, at home or abroad, in or out of town, Castries or Beaufort, Groseley, Ancillary or Canneries, Denry or Babano or Labrie, Black Bay, Rodney Bay, Marigot Bay, Cotton Bay, Ascalette, Aschastney, Lens-Salopuy, anywhere and everywhere in St. Lucia, or if you're with us in London, New York, Toronto, Beijing, Bridgetown, Georgetown, Queenstown, Kingstown, Caracas, Havana, Managua, Belize City, Panama City, Mexico City, Las Vegas or Las Palmas, Nigeria or Niger, Fort-de-France, Pointe-à-Pitre, Port of Spain or Port-au-Prince in Haiti, right now, today, and all of those other places we also get feedbacks from. Welcome to Earl at Large from St. Lucia to the Caribbean and the whole wide world. Bien bonjour tout le monde, tout partout, bonne journée à tout, buenos dias à todos, ni hao, et bon dimanche à tout le monde qui a regardé nous et qui a suivi nous aujourd'hui à ce 17 édition Earl à Gwokod pour premier jour et premier dimanche en mois octobre quand nous avons commencé mois héritage Creole qu'on la coutume en octobre tous les années. Jodia, nous kay parler à la force et puis kouai power Creole à moi héritage Creole ici à st.lucia. Oui. Avec ça kay fait pour l'année ici. Ça c'est l'année 2023. À sous plan nous kay bah information à sous plan pour journée avec moi héritage Creole, journée avec moi Creole, et pour festival la Marguerite l'année ça là, et aussi pour nous qui commencer célébrer 50 l'année place richesse folklore, place là nous qui accueille en anglais et farsi, et ça c'est vraiment commencer comme nous savons. Journée Creole ici, cette liste commence par FRC, place, recherche, folklore. Et que ce n'est pas aujourd'hui, ni mais tout ça est pris ici à ce programme préférence de tous les dimanches. Est-ce que je me dis? Programme préférence tous les dimanches. Eul. À Gwokod. Et qu'à présent, c'est un pour nous commencer l'autre bon dimanche après-midi, comme la coutume, tout dimanche, seulement ici, à Earl à Gwokod. This is Earl at Large. And now for our usual Earl at Large Sunday cooking protocol for the benefit of us all. Like every Sunday at this time, nothing on fire anywhere, inside or outside, stove or oven, coal pot or barbecue grill, no lights on, no fans on in empty rooms in this the hottest period known to humankind on planet Earth. And if you want to know, just look at your light bill, those of you who have to keep fans and AC on for the necessary cooling down in this overheated time, the hottest time on Earth since it started to keep records. So leave no fans on in any empty room right now. In addition, all pipes closed tight, all gates and back doors shut tight, vehicles locked, phones on silent, and your remote put to rest as you give us the test. If this is your first time with us, give us your time. Give us the rest of the 2 hours from 12 to 2, and you can bet you'll never regret or forget. So, we're in your house, on your TV, computers and cell phones, and also live on Facebook at DBS St. Lucia. And here's how to follow, live and direct. Yes, you can follow Earl at Large live and direct every Sunday, and in fact, anytime, any day, at home and abroad, at work or at play. Mi consa.
Introducing a new way to follow your number one leader. The DBS St. Lucia app. View on the go your favorite DBS programming live. Never miss a newscast again. Be up to date with the latest news by tapping the Top Stories tab. Celebrate the life of a loved one at any time through the Obituaries tab. And if you've got a story for our news team, send us your news via our many mediums such as Gmail. Keep track of the weather with our 7-day forecast. It's even easier to view your number one leader with the all-new DBS St. Lucia app. Download today on the Google Play Store or Apple App Store. Visit our website at dbstvstlucia.com for more information.
So now you know, call friends and family, and let's start sharing our weekly table full of food for thought with and over your Sunday lunch or brunch. And as you know, whether you use knife or fork, bottle or spoon, or treat every meal as is simply a finger-licking good, whatever your taste, whatever's on your plate, let's start with our weekly entree with Paul Paba, words of wisdom and messages of inspiration from Monsignor Dr. Patrick Anthony with Jesus Talk, Lucian Talk. Oui, Mamayla, qu'on la coutume à nous commencer dimanche après-midi, nous, avec l'évangile de Monseigneur Dr. Patrick Anthony, avec parole Jésus et parole Saint-Lucie. Je dis à écouter ça et qu'à dire, qu'on la coutume. Mi papa.
Welcome, friends, to Lucian Talk, Jesus Talk, with me, Abba. I would like to thank the officials of the University of West Indies for the honorary degree that they graciously conferred upon me. Thanks profoundly. Sincere thanks to my family, friends and colleagues for their congratulating messages and kind wishes. Lucian Talk. Lalin kui jubawe, which means the moon runs away but daylight catches up to it.
Le nok se ka toujou touche la je se moun la ki ka to avaye pi. I pa te jeme kwe an jou yo te ka chebe yi. Bava te ka toujou di kama wadli, manye yi malis. Yon jou, bosta kouye an fis li pou wepon tet li. Me yi koupe kouye ka di I pa jeme touche la je se moun la. Me le jou awive, kouiz te ka pwey. Piski polis vini awetey fatap. La lin kuwi, juba wey.
Jesus talk. For each man will have to bear his own load. Galatians 6, verse 5. There is a song that goes, you've been running for a long, long time. Yes. Yes. Sometimes we keep running. Running away from responsibilities, running away from challenge. But you see, no matter how much we run, that does not change the challenge. That does not change the responsibility. As our Jamaican friends would say, we have to stand up, we have to man up and accept our responsibilities. So come on, people, man up, accept our responsibility. That's the beginning of development.
Merci, Papa. Thanks, Monseigneur, for today's sermon from Mount Kuba, oui, in both our national tongues. Oui, merci, Papa, pour l'évangile jodia en anglais et en belle langue créole jodia. Okay, ou ka gade Earl a Gwakon. This is Earl at large. Folks, due to a little technical error last week, we were unable to bring you a video we really wanted to share about the influence of artificial intelligence on how we communicate, including this time on how artificial intelligence has taken the role of a preacher in a church. Not here, but in Europe, in fact, in Germany. So, instead, we shared with you a special video on the influence of artificial intelligence and IT on life today, to the extent that robots without brains can be made to host press conferences and offer what sounds like intelligent answers to questions from humans. This week, I want us to look at this other one promised last week on how artificial intelligence, like I just said, is already affecting churches, with the spoken word being preached and the written word being spoken in ways that people see and feel and live through without actually knowing until it hits you in the face or the pocket. Here it is, folks.
Well, here's something interesting for you guys. While you and your family were attending the church service with a human being, a church in Germany has had a church service, as you can see here, that was fully ran by AI. The ChatGPT chatbot led more than 300 people through 40 minutes of prayer, music, sermons, and blessings. Your normal pastor has a soul. Now, whether he's a false teacher or not, that's irrelevant at this moment in time. We are human beings. We have souls. Now, these soulless entities are running churches. They're giving people sermons. What sort of sermon can an AI robot give to someone who doesn't possess the Holy Spirit? Someone without a soul is teaching people the Bible. But here's the scary part. People are listening. Here's exactly what the AI robot spoke. Dear friends, it is an honor for me to stand here and preach to you as the first artificial intelligence at this year's convention of Protestants in Germany. The avatar said, with an expressionless face and a metonymous voice, "These are not your friends. These are demonic entities sent here to deceive you, to deceive your family, to deceive your children, to deceive your husbands, to deceive your wives, your parents. Repent and believe on Jesus Christ. God bless."
Now, like I said last week, I don't know if I shared a view that robots were sent to do us anything, because I do hold that every robot, like I said, is made by a human who does not want it to eventually control him or her. So there must be a way to control it, no matter how many minds it may influence. Like with any computer, you can only download what's been uploaded. So I believe there will always be a way to pull the switch on robots that have no blood, no bones, no brains, no feelings, no hearts. Let's switch them off. And there will always be a way to neutralize the power that drives them. Like I said, just switch them off. Meanwhile, St. Lucia's robotics team that I mentioned of last week has only one more week left to get ready to shine above the rest at the first global competition showcasing IT and AI innovations, which takes place October 7th to 10th, from next week into the middle of the following week. St. Lucia's team comprises 5 young persons between the ages of 13 and 18 who have been diligently preparing for the event, I should say, since July. They will be competing online against thousands of other youth and students from 190 countries through a thrilling game highlighting the importance of renewable energy in this time. So, folks, our young people are also doing very good things. So let's support our and the rest of the Caribbean's robotic teams to rise and shine in the competition against and among the best of the rest in orbotronics, the art of building, programming, and controlling robots. This is Earl at Large. Ça c'est Earl à grand corps. And now for a repeat of this second video from last week by a special request. It's really, like I said, a beautiful story about faith and hope. Watch and listen, but also pay attention to what I like to refer as the kaleidoscopic artistry of the presentation. Judge for yourself. Wepuko.
One day, a man decided to travel by ship with his friends. While in the middle of their journey, the boat began to sink. Everyone tried to escape by swimming, but it was all in vain. All drowned except this man, who succeeded in clinging to a floating object. With the effect of strong winds, the object took him very far, to a small island where there were no men or animals, just a few insects. With the sweat of his brow, he managed to build a small box entirely made of straw. He stayed there for several days, eating fruits, and began to get used to his new life of suffering, even if he did not get used to it. He eventually began to lose all hope of seeing his family again any day. Every night, he lit a fire in front of his house to warm himself. One evening, as usual, he lit the fire. He stayed there for a long time until he dozed off. Late in the night, he was awakened by an overwhelming heat. It was his straw hut that caught fire. He cried, accusing and blaming God, shouting, "Oh God, what have I done to you to hurt me this way? You separated me from my family to bring me to this deserted island. Then you killed all my friends, and now you let my hut burn. Why are you so hard on me? It is better to die, because I am tired of living in this suffering." But at dawn, he saw a small boat coming towards him. When the boat landed, he ran straight for the captain and said to him in astonishment, "Captain, how did you get here? No boat can get there unless he gets lost." The captain replied, "In the night we saw a fire and we thought it was a burning boat, and we did not arrive immediately because the journey was long. We thought that you used the fire in order for us to find you." The man cried, fell on his knees, and asked God for forgiveness. And he got into the boat and went home and reunited with his family. Lesson: God has many ways of solving our problems. You can lose a job and think that God has left you when he wants to give you a better job. Your friends can leave you. Do not believe that the Lord has rejected you. He wants to keep you away from bad companies. Do not curse your God even if you suffer. Keep faith and hope. He will act. This message is a blessing. Do not keep it. Please do as I have done. Send it to all those who are dear to you.
And now for our next share in this section, this time another video that reflects the principle of doing good and encouraging others to do good, even when they do wrong or bad. But it's also about the fact that school days are always happy days, like the Mighty Sparrow sang in one of his more popular songs from the 60s and 70s. And also the fact that it's the things that happen during our school days that we not only remember forever, but which also always shape our lives one way or another. Take this following example. Wepuko.
A young man saw his primary school teacher at a wedding ceremony. He went to greet him with all respect and admiration. He said to him, "Can you still recognize me, sir?" "I don't think so," said the teacher. "Could you please remind me how we met?" The student recounted, "I was your student in the third grade. I stole a wristwatch belonging to my then classmate because it was unique and fascinating. My classmate came to you crying that his wristwatch had been stolen, and you ordered all students in the class to stand on a straight line, facing the wall with our hands up and our eyes closed so you could check our pockets. At this point, I became jittery and terrified of the outcome of the search. The shame I would face after other students discovered that I stole the watch, the opinions my teachers would form about me, the thought of being named a thief till I leave the school and my parents' reaction when they get to know about my action, all these thoughts flowing across my heart, when suddenly it was my turn to be checked. I felt your hand slipped into my pocket, brought out the watch and dipped a note into my pocket. The note read, "Stop stealing. God and man hates it. Stealing will embarrass you before God," and man was gripped with fear, expecting the worst to be announced. I was surprised I didn't hear anything, but sir, you continued searching other students' pockets till you got to the last person. When the search was over, you asked us to open our eyes and sit on our chairs. I was afraid to sit because I was thinking you would call me out soon after everyone was seated, but to my amazement, you showed the watch to the class, gave it to the owner, and you never mentioned the name of the one who stole the watch. You didn't say a word to me, and you never mentioned the story to anyone throughout my stay in the school. No teacher or student knew what happened. This incident naturally taught me a great lesson, and I resolved in my heart never to get myself involved in taking whatever is not mine. I thought to myself, you saved my dignity. Do you remember the story now, sir? You can't simply forget this story, sir. The teacher replied, I vividly remember the story that I found the watch in a pocket, but I did not know in whose pocket the stolen watch was found that day because I searched your pockets while I also had my eyes closed. In life, we need wisdom for everything we do. As parents, teachers, pastors, leaders, etc. We should be able to close our eyes to some things. Not all misbehavior require punishment. Some will need encouragement, some mentoring, and some monitoring. Be a teacher or leader who inspires, not one who shatters.
And if you thought that was all, folks, to wrap up all you've heard above so far from the influence of information technology and artificial intelligence on how we live and pray, to bad things sometimes happening for us for what might look like a good reason, to the things we do at school, living with us forever after, here's this final gem from another generation in another place, yes, also another race, but going through the same experiences of the generational gap across the world, globally, worldwide. That same experience that we go through right here in St. Lucia and the rest of the Caribbean. Our grandchildren, and you will all have heard it or been through it, our grandchildren ask us the same questions we all laugh at because they simply don't realize that, well, we were like them too, and much earlier. Take this young man's testimony from a world in which young people still ask us how we survived without Wi-Fi. Wepuko.
A young man asked his grandfather, "Grandpa, how did you live in the past without technology? Without computers, without drones, without bitcoins, without internet connection, without TVs, without air conditioners, without cars, without mobile phones?" Grandpa answered, "Just as your generation lives today. No prayers, no compassion, no respect, no GMRC, no real education, poor personality. There is no human kindness, there is no shame, there is no modesty, there is no honesty. We, the people born between the years 1930 to 1980, were the blessed ones. Our lives are a living proof. While playing and riding a bike, we have never worn a helmet. After school, we did our homework ourselves, and we always played in meadows until sunset. We played with real friends, not virtual friends. If we were thirsty, we would drink from the fountain, from the waterfalls, faucet water, not mineral water. We never worried and get sick, even as we shared the same cup or plate with our friends. We never gained weight by eating bread and pasta every day. Nothing happened to our feet despite walking barefoot. We never used food supplements to stay healthy. We used to make our own toys and play with them. Our parents were not rich. They gave us love, not material gifts. We never had a cell phone, DVD, PSP, game console, Xbox, video games, PC, laptop, internet chat. But we had true friends. We visited our friends without being invited and shared and enjoyed the food with their family. Parents lived nearby to take advantage of family time. We may have had black and white photos, but you can find colorful memories in these photos. We are a unique and the most understanding generation, because we are the last generation that listened to their parents, and we are also the first ones who were forced to listen to their children. We are limited edition. Take advantage of us. Learn from us. We are a treasure destined to disappear soon.
Yes, folks, we are the world's number one unhidden treasure. The generation that made the transition from the second half of the 20th century to the first two decades of the 21st century. We bring the traditions from the 18th and 19th centuries passed down to our parents and from them to us into the 21st century. And while we might not be wired to the internet, our memories are well wired into our recollections and the oral history in the minds of those in the departure lounge awaiting for the final trip on the one-way flight to destination unknown that we all will have to take. We, this generation, from the last 6, 7, and 8 decades, survived colonialism and independence. We embraced black power and Africa, and we charted the way for the politics of today, where we now call for a second decade of people of African descent, and we also call for reparations, for example, for slavery and native genocide. We might not be as plugged in as our grandchildren, but they are our saviors. They are our lifeguards. When we get drowned or ensnared in the World Wide Web's oceans of information and disinformation and misinformation. Allo, ça c'est Earl à grand corps. This is Earl at Large. This week we have much to cover over right here at home, with the start of Creole Heritage Month and the FRC's 50th anniversary. So we won't have our usual full-length review of local, regional, and international events, except to say that locally, regionally, and internationally, people are very much concerned about the future of Haiti, where at least 4 Caribbean countries up until now have already said that they are ready like Freddy, to have a replay of the Grenada invasion 40 years later in 2023. Folks, the United States led an invasion of Grenada that took place on October 25th, 2023, 40 years ago this month. And from all indications, there is a grand plan for an invasion of Haiti on or before or after or just around that date, 25th October 2023. As if to commemorate the Grenada invasion in Haiti with a similar invasion in the name of a rescue mission, all is set, like I have said and I've always said, for another external intervention in Haiti. Now, having been in and out of Grenada before the US-led invasion, which was sanctioned by the OECS with support from CARICOM member states, and when I say sanctioned here, I mean supported, approved, underlined, and given the okay? So, having been in and out of Grenada before the US-led invasion, I wrote a story that appeared in yesterday's Voice newspaper right here, the first in a series that I will always share with you here and next week. But before next week, let me share with you what was in yesterday's Voice. And as I said in the article, it was also published in the Guyana Chronicle newspaper, where I also have a column, and elsewhere in and out of the region where my articles are usually reproduced. And this is what I said in the article. I've long held that after Grenada in 1983, the next U.S.-led military intervention in the Caribbean would most likely be in Haiti, and I've been proven right. Take the recent Reuters news item dated September 22, last week, Friday, under the following headline, U.S. pledges new aid for Haiti and urges the United Nations to authorize security mission. Now, the article is by somebody called Humaira Pamuk and another called Michelle Nichols. And it goes on to say that the United States, last Friday, like I said, unveiled $65 million US dollars more in help for Haiti's police and urged the UN Security Council to formally back the deployment of a multinational security mission to help the Caribbean country fight crippling gang violence. Speaking at a meeting in New York to address the security situation in Haiti, U.S. Secretary of State Antony Blinken said that the mission would be led by Kenya and it could be deployed within months. That's what he said last month. And he added, "We have no time to lose." The article continues to say that Haiti last year asked for help to combat violent gangs that have largely overrun the capital, which is called Port-au-Prince. And the United Nations Security Council could vote as soon as next week, meaning this past week or the week ending yesterday. That's what the diplomats said last week to show how much they were in a hurry. And in fact, a U.S. drafted resolution, a resolution drafted by the United States supporting a multinational police deployment, was also tabled at the United Nations General Assembly. And Secretary of State Blinken said that while the United States is not providing any troops, the Biden administration will work with the U.S. Congress to also provide $100 million U.S. dollars, apart from the $65 million going to Haiti, to back the multinational mission with logistical and financial assistance. That is what Antony Blinken said. He also said that this could include intelligence support, the CIA, FBI, and all of them, and the spy planes and drones, being able to provide intelligence for the advanced movement of troops. Airlift, they will provide the Hercules C-130 and the big wide-bodied aircraft to fly African and Caribbean soldiers to Haiti. They will provide communications and medical support. And he said that the $65 million U.S. dollars will aim to bolster the Haitian police capacity to dismantle the gangs. The same police force, they say, that can't do nothing, that the people have left, the police officers have left to join the gangs. Now, all of a sudden, that same police force that cannot do anything on its own is going to be given $65 million U.S. dollars to bolster itself to get the capacity to dismantle the gangs. The article continued to report that the U.S. was also imposing a new visa ban on former and current Haitian officials whom Secretary of State Blinken said were enabling the violence. And he said that Washington supports Kenya's vision for a three-part security mission that includes helping the Haitian police, number one, okay, ensuring security for static installations and thoroughfares, number two, and number three, strengthening law enforcement in the long term. All these bright plans for an island nation that they say has lost it and is under full control of gangs. And again, Kenyan President William Ruto told the United Nations General Assembly last week, September 21, that we, meaning the United Nations leaders at the 70th General Assembly, must not leave Haiti behind. But he inherited that agreement, which was signed with his predecessor, Uhuru Kenyatta. So it's not like it's something that he promised. From my understanding, he's more in a hurry to fulfill an inherited fait accompli, which he thinks is a bois, to send 1,000 Kenyan soldiers to fight the gangs the Americans say they are afraid to go and touch down with and fight in Haiti. The article continues to say that countries have been very wary, however, of supporting the unelected administration of Prime Minister Ariel Henry, who has said that fair elections cannot be held with the current insecurity. My God, nobody knew when last Haiti had a fair election. Nobody knew when last Haiti had security for proper elections. Nobody can remember when Haiti was never always under threat of control, either internally by the army through a coup or externally through foreign military intervention, which when the United Nations peacekeeping forces came in after the 2010 hurricane, introduced a cholera epidemic that took hundreds of thousands of lives in Haiti and affected millions of Haitians when you add the effect on the families. And instead of helping, instead of mobilizing the world to help, like they're doing right now for Ukraine, what did the United Nations do? They invoked diplomatic immunity, a legal mechanism to say, not that they cannot pay, not that they are not guilty, but to say we're not paying, because that's too much money and that'll give us a bad name. We just ain't paying that. That is the effect of the United Nations refusing to give reparations to the hundreds of thousands and millions of Haitians who were affected first by the earthquake in 2010 and secondly by the cholera epidemic introduced by soldiers from Nepal who came as part of the United Nations peacekeeping force. And that is why, folks, Haitians at home and abroad tell you they don't want no United Nations forces in Haiti because of what they have suffered as a result of the presence of United Nations forces. United Nations soldiers making children and leaving them and going home. And I am Poussa. And the United Nations is saying they have a law saying that in such cases, it is the soldiers to see about the children. So mothers have to try and contact the soldiers wherever they are with their family happy and not going to be willing to accept the left a child in Haiti. All of these are the reasons why Haitians don't want any external intervention. And they say they don't want that. And it's not just United Nations troops. They don't want no foreign troops coming and bring new diseases into Haiti. They don't want no foreign troops that can't even speak Creole to come and dictate for them how they should live and where they should go. Because they know that those forces are coming to Haiti not to help them get rid of gangs so that they will be free and liberated, but simply to ensure that as a result of the insecurity at present, Haiti does not fall into the hands of rulers and controllers that the United States in particular, but also including Canada, the UK, and others with eyes on natural resources that exist in abundance in Haiti, they do not want Haiti to go in the wrong hands. So back to the article, and it also noted that Haiti has been, like I said, without any elected representatives, no elected government in Haiti since January of this year, and we're in the 10th month of the year, 10 months without government. So-called Prime Minister and President, Acting President Ariel Henry, told the General Assembly last Friday on the 22nd of September, and I'll quote him directly here, My interim government is determined to hold elections as soon as practically possible, and security in Haiti will have to be improved because it has deteriorated to a critical point as criminals feel that they are all powerful. I am going to ask for help to allow Haitians to stay in their homes and to bolster the national police of Haiti so that it can truly respond to the challenges it faces. And the unelected prime minister also called for the United Nations Security Council to authorize that UN intervention. But everybody knows the United Nations Security Council will not authorize that. Not with China, not with Russia, not with those nations that have vetoes, if any of them give proper consideration to the fact that violence doesn't end violence and violence doesn't bring peace. They will be more interested in a peaceful solution, a negotiated diplomatic solution, than fighting to the end, getting rid of the gangs, killing all gang members who, guess what, each have families, relatives, mothers, fathers, children, brothers, sisters, nene, auntie, and bope, like everybody, who will be wanting grievance for their death against who killed them and against who helped to kill them. In fact, the article says, Haiti's most powerful gang leader this week, meaning last week, called for the armed overthrow of the prime minister and acting president, urging Haitians to take to the streets against the unelected government. And Haitians can answer that because they do not want that unelected government, which is inviting foreign troops to come in to legitimize his undemocratic rule. So, folks, the article quoted UN Secretary General Antonio Guterres in a report to the Security Council last month as saying that a robust use of force by a multinational police deployment and the use of military assets by the police is needed to restore law and order in Haiti and to disarm the gangs. Bye, people. Abo di abo fes. And the article ended noting, folks, and take note of this, a multinational police deployment is not a UN mission, which means that what at least four CARICOM countries and Kenya have agreed to is not a UN mission, but a multinational so-called police force deployed to use military weapons. Yes, take police who ride in bike and send them and fly drones. So that multinational police force is not a UN mission, and therefore it will be under the control of the governments, CARICOM, and in Africa, who take responsibility, like in Grenada, for giving the permission to go inside. But when push will come to shove, it will be the $100 million that will be shared among those countries. We already have Kenya and four CARICOM countries, that's five, each of them $20 million US. Is that enough for any CARICOM country, any country in the world to collect as the price for the lives of the Haitians and Caribbean and African fighters and police and translators and other administrative forces who will be supporting the multinational police deployment in Haiti to use military weapons? And folks, I will say that that report that I just quoted reveals enough to support my original position, which still stands today, that the United States has successfully repeated its age-old divide-and-rule argument of justification of an invasion by changing its name from an invasion to a rescue mission. Clearly, to all old enough like me to remember, it's all from the same old, always upgraded and never discarded U.S. psychological operations, what they used to call the PSYOPs playbook, with the same guidelines being used today as in the week between October 17 and the invasion on October 25th, 1983, 40 years ago, later this month. Like back then, in the name of rescuing democracy and saving a defenseless population against armed killers needing to be urgently and violently thwarted by use of overwhelming armed regional, foreign, and international force. In the name of that, they have unleashed the accompanying propaganda blitz that has painted what they describe as armed gangs in Haiti as assassins worthy of assassination in the name of protecting democracy, even though Haiti is everything but democratic, led by an unpopular and unelected prime minister with no elected government and all national institutions to ensure any safe return to democracy after the killing is over and the bodies are counted, the dead bodies are counted. Like in Grenada, folks, Haiti's chapter started off recently with Kenya agreeing to deploy 1,000 troops to Haiti. That's over a year ago. That's before the present president won the last election in Kenya. And the plan was for that to be under a United Nations peacekeeping force. But 1 year later, last weekend, what was supposed to be a United Nations peacekeeping force has metamorphosed into a US-backed, funded, and armed multinational police force. You see what I mean? From invasion to rescue mission. From UN peacekeeping force to multinational police force. But no matter what the name or the description, they're doing the same thing. It's a good idea to fight and kill and ensure the fight and kill until doomsday comes for all who dare stand up against the invading force. But with pre-election pressures topping his agenda and now wanting to have to explain, in fact, and not wanting to have to explain deaths of Americans returning from Haiti in body bags, President Biden has done like in Ukraine and is committing no U.S. soldiers to Haiti. Instead, like in Ukraine, Washington is dangling carrots, 65 million for Haiti and 100 million for the Caribbean and Kenya to support the effort, but from a far distance. Like in Grenada 40 years ago next month, folks, normally progressive Caribbean political press and academic personalities have already started towing the line with amorphous and heavily loaded statements like democracy is under threat and law and order must be restored by any and all means necessary. But such positions, folks, unquestionably support yet another external violent intervention in the long history of Western-led imperial and imperialist orchestrated coups and invasions of Haiti. The West has long determined that the small Caribbean half-island nation, as they call it, because it shares Hispaniola with the Dominican Republic, in that same half-island, black leaders defeated Napoleon and the European armies and the Americans backing them to establish the first black republic in the world and to formally abolish slavery back in 1804. But they have decided that those people, their descendants, must never again be allowed that freedom their predecessors fought for and won so brilliantly. Haiti was forced to pay virtually perpetual reparations to France for the revolution that started the struggle to end transatlantic chattel slavery. But today, as if black lives no longer matter, the US is funding a clear black-on-black onslaught using Caribbean and African soldiers to further legitimize an unpopular prime minister who is acting president of a truly failed state to install yet another transitional administration in Port-au-Prince that will most likely allow the status quo, as things are going now, to allow it to continue and to lead by design to the next military coup. Folks, that is my true position. And even if I might not have the dates right when I say October 25th, because they can still be adjusted to unsuit this argument, the fact remains that the US, the UN, the West, and CARICOM, those countries in CARICOM that have already committed themselves before giving CARICOM a chance to discuss it and come to a collective decision, they are running away from the fact that until and unless someone starts talking to the gangs, they will continue to call for an armed overthrow of the present unelected president, who is counting on an invasion to prop up his illegitimate rule. No one has a written solution to Haiti's problem, but more violence will not bring peace, and those who lose loved ones will always seek revenge. I also continue to hold that the US and other nations wanting to fund a Ukraine-type long-distance war in Haiti with Caribbean and African troops leading must remember that when push comes to shove, like in Iraq, after 20 years of US occupation, they care first when they are leaving, they care first when they are forced out, they care first when they can no longer stay, like the French in Niger, they care first and always for evacuating their own people, and don't care much about local and foreign interpreters and facilitators of the invading foreign forces. Even if Caribbean police are not on the front line of the battle to preserve and protect the illegal regime in Haiti, they will still be regarded as supporters of the invaders, supporters of the foreign forces that Haitians don't like. And if it's one thing the Haitians and the gangs don't like, is the presence of foreign forces. And never mind those who might not be on the front line, never mind those who will not have uniforms, never mind those who will say they are interpreters because Moussa Pale Patois, they will be treated as spies in Haiti, as what we call sous-se. That is what awaits them, likely in Supre. And we have a saying in St. Lucia about how sous-ses die. Let's hope it doesn't apply at all to any St. Lucian who ends up going and participating in what he or she thinks is a worthy venture for a worthy and tidy sum of money. They will not be treated different from the foreign forces they will be facilitating. And remember, Earl Bousquet said so. Meanwhile, folks, I'm following Haiti like a hawk, but until next week, give thought to whether you think Caribbean and African police officers or soldiers have any role helping the United States and other hidden forces who are right now in the open, right now, to do their bidding in Haiti in this day and age when we say that black lives still matter. This is Earl at Large. Sase, Earl Agorkod. And at this point, in keeping with our promise to bring you up to date with the Creole Heritage Month activities for 2023, relax and enjoy the following unveiling of Creole Heritage Month in the following perfect production from the Folk Research Center, FRC. Wepuko.
Adan yon kabawe, yon ka kouye kabawe boots.
Oui.
Ou vle tan pli?
Oui.
Hein?
Oui.
Ou vle tan pli?
Oui.
Lem ekoute. Weste la, ekoute. Mwen ka dizon, bienvini en commune moins en cabaret boots. Ici a ni on chai l'histoire. On chai l'histoire. L'histoire St.lucia qui a commencé ici a et qui aboutit ici a cabaret boots. Pas quoi moi hein? Hein? Tale. Tale. Ah, qui ça quoi boy?
Regardez. Bon, bye, show, guys.
Bye, show?
Oui.
All right.
Ça, yon, on est là.
Ça, yon?
Chairman, qui là. Oui, ok. Chairman, ça, vous. Mais, y'a pas avant, boots.
Chebe, ça. Encore tout, chebe, ça.
D'accord. Qui ça, t'as fait? Femme, pas qu'à moi.
Madame, what can I get you?
Maka boy bagay ki bien fort mais ou pa ni en bas contre toi?
Hein? En bas contre toi? Allez rien. OK, ni pou boy ça. Oui.
Pas qui des mines.
Aïe aïe.
Gaspar.
Chebe ça? Hein? Oui. Bon?
Bon.
All right. Oui. Eh bien, t'as l'air moins de temps tous les deux à ta suis. Qui ça, tu as parlé?
Parle-moi de mes affaires, mon.
Ça, moi. Je
vais parler, puis Michael, maintenant, je suis travail pour moi. Mais Michael, c'est Jean, mais il est de moi.
Ok. Eh bien, ça, c'est place là pour faire ça. Hein? Ici, à Nifoué Cher, bon camarade, et puis, on chai bay pour ce gorge là.
Ah ouais, après on a su ça.
Ah
ouais.
Eh bien, madame, oui?
Oui, moi c'est directeur pour place de recherche folklore. Vous savez, moi, oui, je suis à Poyol qui est venu. En mois d'octobre, je suis à chai travail pour me faire.
Particulièrement, quand l'année ça là, c'est enfin, l'année spéciale pour FRC, vous savez. La richesse folklore. Il a célébré 50 l'année depuis établi. Monsieur! Oui. Oui.
Ok.
Mais plus passer ça. L'année ça là, c'est quand l'année depuis journée qu'on a célébré cette nuit-ci.
Oui.
Eh bien, nous avons un problème à ça.
Pas de problème.
Oui, non. Parce que moun kay vle on chay bay on bay ki go pou jounen kwe on la ni sa ou sa. Oui. Mais
oui ek la ni sa la tant sa la ni sa yo ni un thème spécial ou sa. Ki thème nan?
Papa wè ko wa? Kweyol. Wasin peuple la.
Ki sa?
Kweyol wasin
peuple la. Ça c'est un thème qui fort. Nous la servi thème ça.
Mais le thème
en anglais. Ça ka oui. Creole, the root of the people.
The root of the people. Ça c'est un bail qui fort.
Tale, the root or the roots?
The root.
Oh, the root
of the people.
Ou quoi mat ça parle anglais?
Oui. Thème ça ka jouer pour tout temps au cas.
Oui.
C'est un bon commission qui a donné.
Un bon thème.
Eh bien, dis-nous, qui plan nous ni pour l'année ça?
L'année ça n'a ni un chai plan. Nous kay plus go passé jazz, plus go passé carnival.
Passé jazz?
À commencement.
Blago gab.
Nous kay bay l'honneur pour moun ki ka fait assiwe ki lang kweyol la bien fort. Bien fort.
Ça vwe.
Ok.
Ouais. Avec l'année au chai moun ki sa fait un chai bay.
Avec le témoin d'où? Ekwe sa mwen men avec thème ça là avec célébration journée créole année ça là yo ka point en titan pour yo honorer ces mounan qui ça fait gros contribution pour développement créole pour chaîne créole la vivant n'a parlé di moun kon pa ba moun kon dépolet moun kon prenmos moun kon du bois toutes ces mounan qui ça fait gros contre Marcellus.
Oui, Marcellus Milan.
Oui, comédien même tout.
Mais moun kon ou aussi c'est ma pipi Michael
moun Adam.
Oui, what did you
but Charles moun ka oublier monsieur Adam radio et communication en chaibaire
commissaire.
My dear, yeah. Ou même, so, qui ça? Nous avons un oeil. Nous avons fait un bail avec un grand mise là. C'est grand mise là, il y a fait un musique.
peut-être Grammy Squirrel, nous pas ni $1 million pour bay moun, moi ça gaspote ka jwenn tout l'argent.
Moi gagne no Grammy Squirrel.
Grammy Squirrel ou gagne.
Ya, moi fait. Moi fait. Eh ben, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Soirée Nouvelle et l'Histoire in honor of Creole announcers all around St. Lucia.
Coming to you live from the rooftop at Bellevue on October 6th, Soirée Nouvelle et l'Histoire, a cultural awards evening in honor of Creole media broadcasters
who have contributed to the development of St. Lucia's Creole language and rich Creole culture through television, radio, music, poetry, theater, and other forms. Join us live on social media and national television to be part of this historical moment,
the first of its kind.
The Creole Media Awards. Soirée Nouvelle et l'Histoire. Celebrating 50 years of Creole excellence. Presented by the Folk Research Center.
Wow. Ça, some guy bell. And you know what? I am so honored to be part of such a gala event. October 6th. 2023, mwela! Ula, mwela wa abima, wila wa alila, masabu. Pour tout mois, October, there'll be lots of celebration. And this year, FRC is putting a lot of attention on the reading, writing, speaking of Creole in all forms. And not only speaking, Conte Creole aussi. Moi, chai moun pas sa conte en Creole. So, al chai bagay kay fet en toutes ces différents communes, particulièrement en décommune, l'an espace.
Bon, en toutes ces activités, ça, pas oublier Kabawe Boots. Hein? Pas Kabawe Boots. Pas oublier. OK?
Nous pas oublier. Nous avons fait assez avec tout le monde qui a participé à des activités à nous, ni en sous pays, ni en nos pays.
Bon, l'an est ça là. T'as tenu jouer comment?
Oui, festin jouer.
L'année passée.
L'année passée, la tenue festin jouer. A dit de commune, comme Mabuya Valley, Vieux-Fort et puis Kanawi. Et l'année ça là, nous avons dit de place où nous avons aimé.
En deux communes.
En deux communes, vous voulez savoir?
Oui, je le savoir.
Vous voulez savoir?
Oui.
Nous avons venu, Babouno.
Au café, mon petit cuisinier.
Babouno et puis mon repos. Nous avons allé Mopo aussi. Oh, Sav, mon ka chanje. I remember feste joué.
Oh, oui.
Est-ce que Michael, vous avez joué Chinese skip?
Non, mais tu as joué du fond en bas, mais ma chanje ça.
Et l'année passée, combien de
minutes tu as mis? Tu as mis 3.
Mais on nous chanje ça qui fait l'année passée.
To see the way the young people have embraced the land, the heritage, the Creole, tout bagay Creole, very neat. And this year, it's even more special. Bon ten sa, ki sa nou ka fe pi yo la ne sa la? Ko nou ka y change jounen kwe yo la ba yo?
Chorji, feste jwe, ka y poko. A babo no epi morning pou kote nou ka y kite yo jwe. Ma vle wa ou jwe osi, ya?
Oui, nga jwe, men ma. Ki dat?
Ki dat? Li 15 jou, an mwa oktob.
15?
Oui.
Ok, ok, so, c'est, enfin c'est mois octobre, c'est ça que j'ai dit tout à l'heure?
Oui, en mois octobre.
C'est mois octobre,
en mois octobre.
All right.
Et ça, quand il y a un sud et puis un autre là.
Et un, il y en a un sud, il y en a un autre pays. Et moi je dis sud, je dis moi sud. Ok, je dis moi sud, en south, si vous voulez tenir en anglais, south and the north.
Oui.
En sud et puis un autre pays.
En tout ça, pour l'homme et non, Kabawe Boots. Avec les autres, Kabawe Boots.
Mm-hmm. What's wrong? You can't say that you can't wear boots.
Okay, boots. Okay. So, like, I can't wear a seat on this here. What do you want to know? But, cut me. I don't know what you're doing. For where you're in Creole, you don't know what you're doing in Creole. And I love it. It's the music. You see, music for Journée Creole, it's important, important. It's very important. Like, we need to do something pour célébrer la musique là, pour chaîner la musique là vivant. Bon, qui ça nous a fait? La tenue en fête, l'année passée, la tenue en fête, c'est un violon, changez ça. All right? Et l'année, en fait, tout le vivant, l'année, ça, moi, apprendre l'année en l'autre fête, en l'autre qualité, instrument, musique là. Qui l'a
dit? Écoutez-moi bien, hein? Moi, ça vous aime,
oui, mais vous avez une porte, l'année, ça là. C'est ça, si vous
pas oui, mais là, hein? Moi, je dis que vous avez une affaire, vous avez une affaire. L'année, ça là, nous avons un gros spectacle, nous avons un festival, ouais. The Drum Festival.
Vous avez un gros spectacle.
Le Jésus-Christ te fait miracle. Il transformait l'eau pour venir divin. Mon papa vient en Kabawe pour transformer l'eau pour venir de l'eau. Let me go with fish, yes, if I see. Nadie, some papa, vieux. In his 50 ans. 50 ans de nous commencer. Écoute, là nous t'es commencé ça. C'était Tim à Maïsa. Jeune beau. Jeune beau con. Poutz. Jeune beau con. Docteur Dedica Jules. Danser et puis voir homme. Et puis à présent, vous quand même mon cabaret, vous faites ça. Mais, pour.
Oui, papa.
On nous saluer FRC.
Oui, ça, oui.
50 de l'année. Vive FRC.
Vive
FRC. FRC vivant, vive FRC.
Vive FRC.
Bon, papa, moi, je suis à Square.
Oui.
Moi, je suis à Square. Oui. Où venez-vous ici pour bicycle?
Oui.
Dis-nous ce que vous avez dit. Pourquoi vous avez dit créole?
Oui, laissez-nous commencer FRC. Nous tenions un sens à comprendre que St.Lucia était à perdre la tradition. Si tout en ces villes-là, en habitation, il y aura toujours une tradition. Mais les villes-là, quand vous avez dit que vous êtes un philosophe, il n'y a pas de parler créole, il n'y a pas de danser tambour, et quoi comme ça. Quoi? L'idée, nous, c'était ça. Nous avons dit, nous voulons St.Lucia comprendre qu'il tire ces boudins en pays. Sans pas connaître la culture, sans pas connaître le langage, sans pas connaître l'histoire, sans pas connaître la tradition, sans pas connaître la racine, on pourrait ça de boudin. Et c'est pour ça que nous commençons à faire recherche. Et pour nous, nous menons Jean Castri, habitation, puis nous apprenons ce qui était habitation, puis ça menait Castri.
Tout ça, papa, c'est bien important, mais moi, ça, there are people who do not understand what papa is saying because they've lost the language. And it is true, after 50 years of the establishment of the FRC, what we've really tried to do is encourage persons to appreciate Creole, not just as a language, but as who they are, at the essence of our identity. Mais c'est pour ça nous ni mercredi et puis vendredi créole.
Ok, so vendredi créole, mercredi créole, et qui ça est?
Nous avons encouragé tout même cette nécessité, tout même qui ni place business pour habiller un créole, a floral dress, madras, national wear, habiller un créole, mais li important pour ça. Parler créole seulement à sou mercredi et puis vendredi créole. Et puis si vous voulez faire tak l'argent ou ça, charge aussi ou pas parler créole, tu vas parler anglais.
Bon, moi une question pour papa.
Mais l'idée ça là, j'ai fait mercredi et puis vendredi créole là. Ça c'est un bagage qu'ils a fait l'autre pays aussi. Dominique nous soit ici ça là ou ça.
Oui.
Ah oui, là l'idée là ni jour. Là tout le monde qu'a habillé et puis qu'a parlé créole et qu'a chambé dans le quoi, c'est une bonne idée nous n'avons pas dit. Et si nous savons faire, si tout ce monde est là, c'est en tout en ça, ben il est all right.
Mais quand vous parlez à ce langue-là, vous savez, dit vous aussi même ça la note célébrée à la OAS.
Oui.
Ça fait hâte ça, c'est un bel bain, Marguerite Cavini. Marguerite Cavini. Oui, Marguerite Cavini.
Pourquoi Marguerite Cavini jamais entendu dans le cabaret?
Marguerite Cavini.
Papa, tu veux ça?
ou pas faire un miracle là et pas garder bon pour être qui dit ça pense à papa
dit ah dit café
ah oui.
Ok. Vive la Marguerite!
Ça y est, on parle là, rose ou ça?
Vive la Marguerite!
Royal!
Vive la rose? Vive la rose?
Qui s'est arrivé?
My dear,
microphone.
Tell it. Madame.
Excuse me. Where is you look, where is you. The help?
Let me tell you how beautiful you look. You look royal. Wait.
You got a bliss. You were boots.
So can you assist me? Can you assist me? You in the green shirt.
Yeah. Wow. This is how a queen speaks.
Yes.
What is your supper? I'm when long later.
Yes, please escort me. Thank you.
Wow.
I'm going to take this girl with
Vive la Marguerite.
Vous pouvez dire ça, vous voulez, hein?
Ibelle, mais non, ça vous a chaite. La rose et puis la Marguerite, t'as goûté toi pour moi?
Rose.
Vous voulez vous
finir
avec Vive la Lyon? Mais l'année, ça là, nous jouons ni la rose. Ni la Marguerite qui a venu ensemble, the two flower festivals of St. Lucia, La Rose and La Marguerite, celebrating in union, the rich cultural heritage of St. Lucia. But Marguerite, ça l'a gardé bien, bien belle là. Hein?
Merci.
Mon Dieu, moi, je fais tête de venir plus gros, mon Dieu.
Beautiful flower, beautiful.
Mais c'est pour ça. C'est ça, derrière quoi, côté de nous. Oui, il y a quoi pour lui? Pour fiche. Et qui dit des fleurs, la rose et puis la marguerite, yoka goumé qui en a l'autre, mais yoka goumé enchanté. Pas de physique enchanté. Et qui dit ça, c'est un symbole pour Saint-Lucie. Nous, ça, du bout, ni différence, non? Ou plein flambeau, ou plein étoile, mais nous, ni différence, non? Mais nous, c'est Saint-Lucien.
Mais
ça que vous avez dit? Comme c'est un dit?
Oui.
Vive la rose!
Vive la Marguerite!
Bon, Baba, before.
Vive la Marguerite Royale!
Ok, Baba, yes, Baba, I know this. Baba, où sommes-nous? Baba, pour aller.
Oui.
But tell it, in English. Anything else from you, Baba? You're so special.
Bon, moi, n'allez, où sommes-nous allés d'aller?
Où allez?
Moi, qui allez, Nigeria.
Nigeria?
Oui, Gordia m'a quitté, sort ici. N'allez.
Nigeria.
N'allez, Nigeria.
Wow.
Il est là, en place de il est là.
Mais quoi, tu as dit mon calé là, mais.
Ok.
Non, je ne peux pas voyager. Mais, moi, je veux tout le monde savoir.
Dernière parole,
ma belle. Nous, nous pouvons mener des associations, la Rose et puis la Marguerite, ensemble. Et puis, journée, créole, nous avons un grand messe côté, nous avons la Rose et puis la Marguerite.
Wow.
Et ça c'est un symbole d'union. Quelle est l'union? Quelle relation nous voulons en cette lycée?
D'accord.
Pour ça,
La paix.
En cette lycée, la paix entre Marguerite et puis la rose, la paix entre Popette. Bye bye, maman est là.
Dédé, papa. Quoi, dépend nous, hein?
Papa, on dernier bail avant.
Quittez nous là, allez, pour l'avion.
Papa, on plaît. Bye bye.
Bon vol. Bon voyage. Oui,
now, nous n'y belwen, ça là, nous voulons connaître plus. Queen Junior.
Bon.
Maman.
Qui plan pour Marguerite l'année, ça là? La Wen Royal.
Est-ce votre plan?
Nous n'y a plan.
OK.
What we have planned to do is to have community séances où on save la Marguerite. So from September start to October would be the community séances. Et CDF ka faire by nous kay ni comme si nous kay of festival school drive. Wow. Where the La Marguerite groups will go to schools and educate the students about the dance, the song, the meaning of La Marguerite, and the difference between the two flowers, Ohasav. There is a difference. And we're also going to do training programs for the groups in terms of, you know, their organization. So we have a plan, but instead of me telling you, let's see what that is.
Vive la Marguerite Royal. The La Marguerite Societies and the Cultural Development Foundation presents La Marguerite Celebrations 2023, a royal affair. The celebrations start with the La Marguerite Grand Ball on October 14th, featuring world-renowned St. Lucian chefs and appearances by La Marguerite groups from around the island. And to top it off, the Hoar Fête, October 16th, starting with a church service at St. Joseph the Worker Church in Rose Lane, and then on to climax on the streets of Rodney Bay. Vive la Marguerite Royale!
You go, girl. I thought it was because you saw me, you turned blue.
Vive la, bon, let me tell you. Bon, l'année, un chai bagay qui a fait l'année salaire ou ça. Particularly the Creole media.
Oui.
And so, I, because I'm in media myself, I would like to encourage. Interdit en Creole. Na encourager toutes ces monde en les radio, en les télévision pour faire assurer l'année ça là. Ni faire programme en Creole. Apprendre compter toutes ces bagages là en Creole, mon ca encourager toutes ces monde à sur radio et moi veut tant yo tant moi. Tout monde fait un bagage pour Creole l'année ça là. Ça c'est en octobre pour marcher moi. Comment c'est organisé? Yo ça croyez moi si vous voulez. Moi là.
Michael, ça vous dit bien important. Mercredi Creole, c'est différentes stations télévision et puis radio ni pour faire si vous qui yo mettez Creole là devant. Mais avant nous venir pour ça, when la te ka parle à sou La Marguerite Royal. Mais il faut qu'on dit nous date là côté bagay là.
Mais Zod Patton.
Mais nan mwa de wako. Nou de ka bawe moun ka jwe moun ka bwe. And we want to hear it in English too, because we know the Marguerite a lot.
Scotch here.
Scotch?
You drink scotch?
Yes.
Oh, oh yes. My God. Please, hello. And hey, a royal drink, please. Hmm? A royal drink for her.
A royal drink?
You yes. Want it on ice?
Oh, no.
As I was saying, the 14th of October is the La Marguerite Grand Ball. And of course, we'll be celebrating, so that will start at 7 p.m. And on the 17th of October is the Hoar Fête in Grosse Île. Yes, Rodney Bay.
Rodney Bay.
Rosalie again?
Mais, eh ben bon.
Marguerite?
Mais ça peut faire ces mouns, ça.
Nous pouvons faire ça.
Okay.
Can I get a glass? I don't think that's fitting.
Mais,
Madame Sarah.
Ok, nous pouvons quitter Madame Lepati, hein?
Tu peux me faire ça?
So. The 14th of October, the La Marguerite. Oh, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. And I will not drink, I'll just smell it.
You smell it.
Thank you. The 14th of October, the La Marguerite Grand Ball, and the 17th of October in Grosse Île, La Marguerite Hoar Fête. I hope to see you all there.
I will be there.
Bye, madam. Bye.
Excuse me. The help.
Okay.
I'm leaving now.
Bye-bye.
Places to go, people to see.
Very nice.
I don't get into squabbles.
Royal.
Vive la Marguerite.
Royal!
Merci. Ça me regarde bien.
So, ou te kadi décorer business? Oui, me
regarde pour bien business. Enfin, nous voulons tout le monde participer. La, quand nous dit, l'année de la messe, l'année jouer, l'année. Enfin, avec nous qui encourager ces gens business là, c'est l'école là, toute organisation.
C'est kabawe, comme kabawe bout.
So, moi ça, décorer, kabawe ça, avec nous qui jouer non plus.
Oui, ou quand
il y a un bagage. Moi,
je suis obligé.
Ah.
Pour dire mon oblé.
Ma mettre un blé.
Oui, hein.
Pièce blé à dedans.
Oui. But you know that Kabawe Crawl Initiative is part of the St. Lucia Tourism Authority's brand to ensure that, you know, culture is infused in the experience of visitors.
And I really love it. Kabawe Crawl. Really?
A shame mon
quoi. Do you have to crawl in there?
Crawl? Mm-hmm. Ou voulez crawl, Gaspar?
Massa.
But ma se ou Mm-hmm. Mwete to bagay di da boye Gaspar. Ivle crawl di da kabawe?
Oui. So kabawe crawl, c'est quand zo kakouye?
Kabawe crawl.
And the St. Lucia Tourism Authority, is it? Isn't it? Eh ben, Gasa.
Mama. Is it Shimizu
Lakadi? I'm Anglais. I am endorsed.
You're endorsed?
Oui. Balame, come on, boots.
Kabawe boots.
Very good. Ibon.
Actuellement, on va parler.
Oui, nous allons parler.
Cabaret pour ta dame.
So, ça veut dire le cabaret call ça. What's that? Avec un t-shirt. Qu'est-ce
ça? Moi, mes plans pour cabaret. Moi, mes plans pour tout cabaret et tout commune simple ici. Oui.
Mais nous savons, gros journée à tout le monde qui veut participer. Vous avez habillé belle, vous avez mangé, vous avez boire, vous avez oui, mais c'est journée pour vous.
Eh bien, bon.
Il 29, pas oublié.
Woman.
Woman, là, vous voulez
pas. Si vous n'avez pas de woman, vous êtes mal.
Venez ici.
Bon.
Woman. Obligé, jeune lui.
Chanter, nous qu'à danser, nous qu'à manger.
Même pas, ouais, ça. Vite à la personne, pas une chine, pas c'est là. Mon.
Top privé, nous qu'à parler, quoi. Danser, quoi. Chanter, quoi. Top privé, nous qu'à parler, quoi. Parce que quoi, c'est langue maman. Chanter.
Chaque information nous a baillé
à
ce jour n'est qu'au lendemain ça là. Et témoin de moins excité, mais moins les savent. I want to know how can the media help.
Nous ni je vous savent. Nous juste sur quoi NTN et PGIS et puis l'autre monde quoi Jason Joseph Kaiwe de nous pour faire assurer que tout juste ici et puis étranger aussi connaît tout ça nous a fait pour moi étage quoi. Now. Où ça va aussi nous niger comme une lampe? Est-ce qu'il va aussi bien faire comme une lampe?
I was just about saying, what kind of malhonnêteté is that? Like, just see people just rich on us there and I don't understand.
Ça, c'est jamais. Ou quand il est pour toi, tu es bon. Yo même quand il dit, qui moun yo yé? Et puis, qui ça yo quand il fait l'année ça là pour aider nous? Pour chen, moi, ou t'as choué, ou les pigeons et aussi. So, do you know? Bienvenue, Mala. Oui.
I am Lynche Antoine, chairperson of the Creole Committee. Moi c'est Jacques Kanawi.
Ah, mon corps
m'a sorti Kanawi.
All right.
Plus, like, plea for a kilte, a set lisi.
Boom! Papa, comment c'est presque un cobala?
Non, mais le temps ça les autres, like I did.
Mais le temps aussi. Oui. Dis-nous qui ça Kanawi qui a fait l'année ça
là. Nous n'y a chai plein l'année ça là. The plans really is to demonstrate our rich culture. I'm not sure if you know, but I'm saying that Kenries is a community that has been stuck in time as it relates to culture. This is a community you come to, especially on a Saturday, and you still see the ladies with their basins on their head, kale bola ivie lave, si mama yo de yo ni se bom la ka trebe. So this is something that started, well, long ago, and we still kept that. We will come to our community in the evening and find families still sitting on their steps telling stories. You don't see that anywhere on St. Lucia.
Mais dis-moi plus, hein. So, on est pour marcher à l'écart,
oui. Ouais, c'est qu'il te, ça, là. Moun still ka fait coup de main. Moun ka fait kai pa coup de main, kanawi, toujours. So, ça pour moucho, manier qu'il te a fort, toujours, kanawi. OK? So, St. Lucia, là, ou ka swezi a place pour venir pour jeûner kweol, kanawi, c'est place, là.
Kanawi, c'est place. Non, madame Kabo, je vous dis, je vais venir pour moi des questions à ce qu'on nous savons, dis-moi.
Oh, non, moi, c'est ça, of course, mais c'est belle, tu m'as qui sorti, place qui plus belle. Ou ça venir là, ou ça, je vais plus belle manger tout, place souffouillé. Je souffouillé là, Rodia. So, nous, nous, tout calte, bagay, ba ou bon manger, boti musique. Mais oui, et vous savez, nous avons Belty Sulphur Springs, Belty Bagay, so vous savez, pour un petit bé à point.
Souffle.
Vous savez.
Souffle is in the house.
Right.
So pour aller souffler, moi, ça m'a fait passer Kanawi, na aller souffler. So qui ça n'a joué dans souffler?
Eh bien, souffler, ni un chai bagay, mais n'y a pas un petit aglé. So nous avons commencé avec. Premier jour octobre, we have the launching of our Creole Heritage Month. And of course, in Soufre, it's a whole month of activities. So with our launching, you could expect our Jouvet, and you can expect to engage in our greasy pole, our greasy pig, our swimming racing, our canoe racing, and so much more. Then we are going down to our communities from the 6th of October. So
greasy pole, greasy pig?
Yes. On the 6th of October, we have the history of the free people. Of course, that will be spearheaded by the Monjalib Development Committee. And we will be in Forjalib on the 6th.
Monjalib?
Yes. October 7th. Roule là-bas, bagay nous kotan, nous ka aller au bel fond. Then, roule là-bas, pas qu'à juste du bout à bel fond, ça, nous ka descend au bouton, October 8th. October 11th, our tour guides in collaboration with the Soufre Regional Development Foundation will be giving us all a tour of our sweet town of Soufre. October 14th, nous cadessons à Zeno. Nous avons des bambou busting et quail dans le circle. October 15th, nous avons des cocoa festival et ministry agriculture. October 21st et 22nd, jeunesse quail pageant. Septima mai, kai vini, mouchouenou sa yoni. Oui, mais nous sommes soufouye, c'est bagay la yé la ni sa la. October 25th, nous avons des food. Arts and Crafts Affair, hosted by Chateau Bel Air Community on the Fordu Field. Ek, ou sav? 29 octobre, c'est Jounou. Soufre Mini Stadium. C'est là bagay kaye.
Kaye?
Oui.
Ok. Isam nani pou fè, Rum the Island. Na koumanse a kanawi, na desen soufouye.
Non. Ou ni pou... Vini soufouye denye.
Daniel,
so who sounds so stand by you just fire
you to tell it to fear what happened to Satan.
C'est nous qui sommes plus forts en qualité. Parce que nous avons tout ça, nous avons dit, et nous, seuls comme nous, deux groupes, trois groupes, Marguerite, nous solo, nous avons dansé compte, des bottes, quoi d'huile, c'est tellement la capacité, topio, cabaoué. Toute qualité de bagaille qui a été fait en Valia. Laver, bon, la vie, tout ces bagailles ça. So, nous avons oui, merci, c'est Jean Valia pour quitter la qualité. Oui. Denis Rivière, font piti.
Font piti. Beaucoup de bonne gaga cochon.
So nous n'y a chai activité. So depuis autant de vendredi, point bagou, nous n'y a chai côté pour ça. Des point bagou et donc à vie mouté lundi. Parce que depuis autant de 1er octobre, nous commençons et puis la messe, et puis tous les week-ends, nous n'y a chai bagay kapanko.
Michael. Ou sa tout sa ekadi, mwen kadi mwen kite kay mwen mwen ale mabouya vale?
Mwen kadi mwen kadi mwen kadi mwen 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 koumanse, let me say that in English, I'm going to book an Airbnb in each of these communities, ki se domi nga domi chak jou. Yes,
bon,
each of them.
Bon, Michael, mwen se a ek madame, ek se madame la, sa pale telman, zot. Qui m'a dit, qui rote un autre, vous voulez un petit ouzé, ou ça va aux autres? Oui, on va contre tout ça.
A shy activity due moi October. So St. Lucians and visitors alike can look forward to a park program and a number of initiatives, especially television programs.
Le ou aller au Kiyo Avoka, ou pas sa parler anglais, et c'est créole, bien seulement ou ka parler. Ou sa, le bahat la shy duty. Doesn't create
that. They want to go to one room two. If one room two can be a shame, one of the
all. Lanius Tickenberg, King, you as 30 said, need lead if you need to public will.
What do you give your man? To say, for the Lanius natural man, shut, let's shut for that.
C'est l'argent, on appelle l'argent, mille l'argent. Hein?
Why encore? Why I'd like to see more access to Creole language.
Why? Our grand and great grandparents, that was what they was using.
So they pass on the knowledge to the people that wanted to learn it, which is people like me that was interested. So with that, I become a traditional healer using herbs.
A lot of information, on that Creole language. Idi, how can we help disseminate that kind of information?
Well, c'est pour ça que je viens pour aider. Moi, je parle chai, mais je ne parle pas comme moi seulement. Well, traditional media will help us out. We have GIS and NTN. Our private sector partners in the media will help out too. But also important, puisque ça, tout le monde est sur TikTok, you are sur WhatsApp, you are sur media social.
TikTok.
Oui, TikTok. Ou sur TikTok,
not
Michael?
Not a game, they play.
Pas TikTok là, ou quand jouer. TikTok, you know?
Oh, OK.
Oui, comme ça.
TikTok, TikTok, moi connais.
Oui, TikTok, pas TikTok. Ça, c'est un bail qui différent.
OK.
Mais où ça va mon cas aider nous? Mais c'est Jason Joseph. Il a fait Jason Joseph. Où connaît l'école Bachelor?
Oh, Bachelor!
I saw what you did last...
Moi connaît lui.
Jason, nakuye Jason. Jason, Mimi Jason.
Et bien, par ordine, on a essayé de faire Saint-Lucien pour un langage la plus sérieux. Parce que les gens qui parlent créole tout le temps, ils ont des médias sociaux, ils ont écrit créole, mais ils ont espéré mauvais. Quand même, les gens pour un langage la plus sérieux, si vous avez servi tout le temps, allez plus loin et apprendre à lire et écrire. C'est ça tout seul, mais vous voulez faire. Pour un langage la plus sérieux. Parce que nous, mais nous avons servi, nous avons fait des blagues tout le temps. Pour un bagage la sérieux, respecter langue créole la paix, c'est ça?
Oui, mais où savent nous ni en compétition pour maman l'école? Dis-nous plus ça, comment ça vous a aidé nous pour faire assurer que toute jeune maman qui a participé pour yo mouchoué nous? Qui manye yo kwe yo sa mouchoué film créole ou asin peuple?
Oui, enfin, je suis excité tellement de m'étonner ça. Parce moi toujours que ces jeunes qui m'ont là, ces étudiants primaire et secondaire, est important pour mettre yo à dans bail qu'on passe les nous aller. C'est yo qui continue tradition, oui, et compétition, yo ni pour préparer un petit vidéo. Il ca durer 1 minute et yo ni pour expliquer bail l'opinion yo à ce sujet à créole ou assin peuple là.
Creole, the root of the people.
Oui, et qu'on est pour expliquer ça, by l'opinion, y a source qui ça y a quoi il veut dire. Et moi, c'est important pile parce que quand il y a une occasion pour faire un petit recherche, pas yo tout seul, mais c'est teacher. Quand il y a une occasion pour faire un petit recherche pour apprendre plus à ce qu'il tient ou à ce langue créole, nous, moi, c'est assez un bon idée et même pas ça espérer.
Bon, ok, mais d'accord avec ça. Bon, à qui l'est l'autre manière? Yo ça servi média social, c'est ma jeunesse là en particulier. À part des compétitions ou pas là.
Eh bien, tout le monde qui a servi média social, tout là, expressement en moi créole, tout le monde ni, yo ka fait flash, yo ka font portrait, yo ka fait des vidéos, ça nous voulait yo faire vidéo à ce sujet par exemple, faire une petite compétition, c'est travailler à côté au travail, faire une petite vidéo. Yo ka essayé parler un petit créole, yo ka espélé deux ou trois mots, yo ka espélé bien, yo ka dit deux ou trois paroles avec expression créole. La ni chay bagay moun sa fait, mais nous on est ni pour organiser, pour faire assurer yo participer. Parce que si nous pas fait ça, moun ka y fait ça yo vle, ça ka y oublié, ça ka y prend temps avant y faire ça. So, nous ni pour faire assurer moun participer. Mais yo toujours sur les médias sociaux. Et que pas ka y ni un problème avec ça.
Ek, ek, ek.
Oui, depuis nous n'est pouibou pour bayo, moun ka participé. N'a dit ça. Et matin jè à se danser à ça important aussi. Ki mani an pays ça célébrer, bruyer et moun pa danser, ça qui vive zot. Nous ne pouvons danser, oui. Encourager ces places business là pour faire un petit vidéo. Il y a un appel à la commette, un petit moulin là.
Nous allons chanter et danser aussi.
Oui, mais oui, aussi, oui.
Qui a venu ici là. Même pas où? Oui, tous les jours ici là, en cabaret boots. En belle madame. Jason, moi, je voulais vous promouvoir. Pousser madame Sala
en
média social. Ok, les mains dit madame Sala ça chanté, madame Sala ça chanté. Ok, qui dit il y a une chanté bon
sous la peau si maman et moi ouais sous la bois si maman là ouais sous la peau il moule il pas bon j'y vais qu'à manger ça. Moi dis maman, moi pas te veux content. Moi dis maman, moi pas te veux joui. Moi dis maman, moi pas te veux content. Ich moi vagabond, j'y bien qu'à manger ça. Un petit pied poyé, il s'est ni détiflé. Un petit va vini, il jette tout à terre. Un petit pied poyé. Il était né, il flé, un petit vent vini, il jetait tout à terre. Boy, Tindai, ma caille pas ou Tindai, Tindai pour Tindai, ma caille pas ou Tindai, boy, doudou, ma caille pas ou Tindai, Tindai pour Tindai, ma caille pas ou Tindai, Isabelle, Babello, Isabelle, ma cabau, Benno, c'est Bahou, ma cabau, c'est Bahou, ma cabau. Mama la di why, why? Di why oh ho, why? Di why toujours, why? Di why oh ho, mama la di why, why? Di why oh ho, why? Di why toujours, why? Di why oh ho, let me turn your baby, c'est pas où me parler, let me turn your baby, c'est pas où me parler, why no jiwe yo, why no jabat mama, why no jabat papa.
Subitement, accordez-moi de rester ici encore. Allez.
Moi qui ai représenté, si vous avez servi,
allez,
comme ça, bizarre, grand, mais plus belle passée à Mariah Carey, qu'à chanter plus passée.
Mais vous changez ça, ça, Jason Dia, danser, il n'y a pas de danser, puis vous passez à nous canter belle musique, ça là, et vous pas danser, calé, puis moi d'accord. Oui, oui. Et tiens ça, bon, tiens ça, où est tout ça nous a parlé là?
Oui.
You see all of these things we talk about there?
Eh bien, ça.
L'année, ça là, moi content. I just love the way the government of St. Lucia has been promoting Creole independence, emancipation. Wait, the list is too long, and they just keep getting better and better and better. Pas d'accord?
Mm-hmm. Oui, mais tant ça, c'est pour ça que j'ai invité un jeune ici, vous savez.
the parliamentary secretary in the Ministry of Culture.
Kimon?
Mr. Gibian Foden, me ka vini. Gibo, you ka vini. Hey, man.
Ay, ay, ay.
Oh, welcome, welcome, welcome.
Welcome, sir.
Welcome, welcome, welcome. Welcome,
sir. Parliamentary secretary, Kimon, you're right.
Sigwete a palama,
po. Oh, Kimon, welcome, sir.
Okay.
Si boot, sa fè. Merci, 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 boot. Como sa pointe y assis? Ah, oui, merci, merci.
Bali, abwe. Welcome to Kabawe Boots.
Oui, moi ça vous aime. Bon, un petit loco, un petit loco. Majer for all by. Aïe, aïe, aïe. Gaspar, Gaspar, aïe, aïe.
Un petit loco,
welcome, welcome, welcome.
Merci.
So we're happy, we're very happy to have you.
I am happy to be here. Merci.
And to Boots, to what you call it?
For the fruit.
Kabawe Boots.
Si moi puis Gaspar, aïe.
No, Bible.
Good for the front, man.
A
shy return, nous avons parlé à ce jeune Creole, et puis moi, oui, tâche Creole, et que pas connaître qui est le gouvernement qui a joué, qui vision on pour qu'il tire cette nice, le gouvernement cette nice.
Bon, avant moi, dis ça, pour moi, dis-en, tu vas quand même observer, moi, tant que FRC, qui a célébré 50 ans,
50 ans,
pour ça, FRC, et puis moi, nous même l'âge.
Ouais!
Moi, tourné 50 ans en juin l'année ça là.
Ah, oui.
Moi, j'ai fait en 1973. Ça, c'est 1973.
Wow.
Et puis, les moi, j'ai 50 ans, moi, j'ai dit, moi et puis FRC, nous même l'âge. Après, je suis bien content.
Ça, c'est une bonne manière pour commencer.
Oui, oui, oui. Bon, gouvernement, c'est ici. Moi, je crois qu'on a changé le premier ministre, le premier fait la Dwesli, le adressé St.lucia après l'élection. Il fait, tout le monde savent qui à présent, à partir de 2021, il voulait l'émancipation, manière nous célébrer St.lucia, il voulait nous changer ça. Il voulait nous faire ça grand bagage. Il voulait affaires créoles, folklore St.lucia, il voulait nous prendre ça plus sérieux. C'est pour ça qu'on a ouais qui emancipation, ça fait émancipation. Ils ont fait fête la rose et puis la marguerite. Ils ont fait kilti héritage, moi héritage. Pour qu'à ouais manière nous qu'à faire ces bagages ça là, mais plus significance. Nous avons laissé l'école là. Bon, maintenant madame Natalia là qui a dit ou à de l'eau abattement, mais moi même si on, moi pas la rose, hein. On va faire autre chose ça. Moi même si on marie, oui. Bon, moi t'es qu'à soupirer comme moi, mais lady ça m'a de ce quoi.
Mais ça fait des fausses quoi. Tu vois, ouais, dans Kabawe Boots, moi t'es police là, mais si vous commencez à gommer là, mais ça fait des fausses.
Moi t'es ni pour déclarer ça, hein. Mais nous ça vivons ensemble. Comme t'es qu'à dit, gouvernement qui a fait assiouer, qui a présent, ils a fait kilti, ils a fait éducation kilti, ils a fait manière nous qui a célébré kilti nous. Nous avons pris ça sérieux et puis nous avons plus de significance. Parce que si nous n'avons pas fait ça, nous n'avons pas fait génération après nous, entre et puis connaître manière nous avons célébré qu'il y a un mort. C'est pour ça que le gouvernement s'est laissé. À présent, quand le gouvernement et puis toutes les autres, c'est FRC, et puis Invest St.lucia, et puis toutes les autres organisations, nous avons travaillé pour faire assurer. Et puis toutes affaires identité, les affaires qui a célébré qui m'ont noué comme Saint-Lucien, nous avons ça plus sérieux.
Bon, là, il y a une autre question, moi, je m'en dis, à part de tout ça, dit là, moi, tant, ma savez, oui, comme que le gouvernement a mis créole en l'école, est-ce ça, oui?
Oui. Si vous regardez les affaires à manifester, nous, nous avant nous gagner l'élection, nous avons dit que nous voulons étudier, nous voulons mettre le créole en langage, qui est un curriculum, qui est l'école. Pour tout le monde, depuis que nous avons commencé l'école, nous avons appris pas seulement le langage créole, mais aussi l'histoire de Saint-Lucie. L'histoire de Saint-Lucie et puis l'histoire de Caraïbes. Bon, ça est important parce que si vous êtes un jeune monde qui vit en Saint-Lucie, ou pas connaître l'histoire de place, ou pas connaître l'histoire de pays, ou pas connaître l'histoire des gens, ou perdu.
D'accord.
Alors, ce n'est pas l'histoire de l'Angleterre tout seul nous qu'on apprendre. À part des affaires de langage, là, nous aussi, nous voulons faire assurer que toute maman et l'école, c'est ici. qu'à apprendre l'histoire Saint-Lucie et puis l'histoire Caraïbe.
Belle parole, bon travail, même si vous êtes en Marguerite.
Mais, non, peut-être tout ça, j'ai dit nous. Ou dit nous, à ce travail pour moi, au étage créole, créole à l'école, nous savons qu'à l'école aussi, ça c'est ministre, tout, oui, c'est Pikilti. So, donc, à pousser, mais qui ça, Joseph, ça fait pour faire assurer qu'il nous célébrer qu'on nation.
Ce qui est plus important pour moi, c'est nous n'y pour venir ensemble. Chaque fois, le gouvernement, et bien, n'importe l'autre organisation qui a fait un effort pour célébrer n'importe affaires héritage nous, nous besoin chaque commune, chaque place, tout petit tout en cette ici pour participer. Et puis, si vous changez manière de émancipation l'année passée et puis l'année ça là, ou quand ouais tout différent comme ni un monde là et ben anti groupe en yonde qui participer parce que c'est là nous participer là nous bail tout monde en chance pour qu'on nous a dit own what we do pour qu'on nous a pour un stakeholder on y a ou quand ouais qui significant soit de bagaille là ou qui supporter quoi nous voulons encourager Saint-Lucien pour participer en toutes ces différentes activités à nous kaini à sous affaire héritage.
Mais c'est moi tout l'année ça la créole la caille go. Or quoi c'est blague là. Créole la caille plus go l'année ça. T'as le touriste qui descend pour jouer créole.
Obligé. Il faut sortir au lieu au pays là, au lieu au Kawaii là, l'angnité et l'autre pays. Nous quoi? On va aller go quoi jouer créole parce qu'il y a ni mon qui a venu visiter cette nuit-ci.
Mais oui, parce que ça fait touriste là. L'année mon qui a quitté Placio pour venir cette nuit-ci. Seulement pour apprendre manière nous ka vivre.
Oui.
À présent tourism nous ni bagay ka nous ka servi authentic experience. La c'est pas pour la plage et puis pour ou sa bagay hôtel tout seul yo ka venir. Yo vle aller fondou, yo vle aller faire cabaret crawl, yo vle sa côté ki babou no. Yo vle low bayo. Yo
vle venir cabaret boots.
Oui, cabaret boots. Et puis yesoue ba kontwe a. Yo vle sa ki sa ki a dan.
Nous pas parler de yo, pas de yo si que nous.
Pas obligé de yo, mais ou ka baye on ti idée. Est-ce que là ou baye on bagaille manger? Yo vle savent ki man yo ka préparer, yo vle wè, yo vle faire ou moutoué yo. Ada yo juste vle participer, yo vle faire yo aussi. Et puis c'est ça en chai tourist à présent, c'est ça yo ka apprécier.
Oui.
Yo vle venir et puis aller à tout petit coin place.
Apprécier qu'il ti place.
Oui, et puis vivre con nous-mêmes.
Oui, vivre con nous-mêmes.
Yo vle faire ouais toutes ces bagailles là zote ka fait là. Vous voulez faire, vous voulez danser pour, vous voulez apprendre ses pas, tout bagaille.
Moi, je voulais battre pour aussi, avec manger, je le prochain, avec
différents bagailles. Vous allez pour en dire merci.
Ah oui, merci.
Merci.
Merci. Merci. Merci. Merci. Merci. Merci. Merci. Merci.
Merci. Merci. Merci.
Merci. Merci. Merci. Merci.
Merci. Merci. Merci. Merci. Merci. Merci. Merci. Merci. Merci. Merci. Merci. Merci.
Merci. Merci. Merci.
Merci. Merci. Merci. Merci. Merci. Merci.
Ok.
Merci. Merci.
Merci.
Merci.
Merci. Merci. Merci.
Merci. Merci. Merci. Merci. Merci.
Merci. Merci. Merci.
Chanter, nous ka danser, nous ka manger.
Même pas ouais ça. Vite les personnes pas en Chine, pas c'est là. Mon amour.
Top privé, nous ka parler créole, danser créole, chanter créole. Top privé, nous ka parler créole, parce que créole c'est langue maman. Chanter. Top privé, nous ka parler créole, danser.
Mais j'ai parlé pour lui.
Commencer
1er octobre. Pour 31 octobre l'année, ça là. Saint-Lucie qui a. Oh yo 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 yo.
Vous avez assoudi fait pas qu'on casse.
Non, mais assoudi fait. Mais en chai bagay, l'année, je n'ai pas eu. L'année, toutes ces différentes bagay, là, nous parlons. Mais t'as l'air, moi, j'ai oublié de les ministres qui là. Qui. Ça, c'est agence touriste. Qui a poussé ça? C'est. Qui m'a dit que vous avez appuyé? St.Lucia Tourism Authority.
Oui.
You can find shite of it.
You can find shite of it.
You're doing a lot of work.
Oui, ça oui.
Then, Monsieur Bayon, let me come. Give them a round of applause.
Oui, nous savons faire ça.
A round of applause.
Oui, nous savons faire ça. A round of applause. Mais, je voulais applaudir. C'est juste cette nice aussi, puis moi, ça, juste cette nice. Vous avez une nature en moi, vous avez une couille. Vous avez habillé une couille, vous avez parlé une couille, vous avez mangé une couille. Vous avez juste venu à Kabawe Boots pour vous amuser une couille. Changer, je n'ai pas une couille. Il y a 29 jours. Il y a 29 jours. Je suis ici à l'Angleterre.
Octobre. 29 jours.
29 jours en octobre. Vous avez descendu cette nuit ici. Nous allons aller à Kanawi. Nous allons aller souffrir.
Oui.
Et puis nous allons aller à Mabuya Valley. Pour nous, amuser avec nous, dis-moi, moi, où est-ce que
tout partout.
Bon, je vais vous fermer le cabaret parce que madame, moi, là, qui a SP, là.
Madame, vous avez SP?
SP, là.
Bon Dieu.
Là, je vais vous fermer le ok?
Toute la vie même, mon pas j'ai fait mes cabaret.
C'est bon ici, ah, merci pour venir, c'est mon là. Mais nous pour sortir, là il faut faire mes places. Moi, j'ai qu'à espérer pour tenir l'histoire. J'ai qu'à espérer pour tenir l'histoire. Ok. Qui t'es tambour à sonner? Bring the drums. À nous coûter drum là, tambour. Où les tambour? Où les tambour? Oui.
Danser, créole, danser, créole, chanter, créole.
And from here, we thank you for staying with us, wishing you all the best for the rest of today. I'm Earl Buske, inviting you to join us again next Sunday, same time, same place, for our next edition of Earl at Large, right here on DBS. Hey.